My name is Maurice W. Sanders, and I am a photographer. My images behind me were taken in Haiti in 2013. The four images that are exhibited are part of my Global Faces collection. That is a collection of people that I portraits that I've taken all over the world. So I've been to all seven continents, and I take a lot of portraits, and that is part of the Global Faces project collection. The image right here, the first one I'm looking at, is a picture of Rosalie, and she is the granddaughter of the cook at a senior citizen's home in Haiti. And she's allowed to clean the pot, which is red beans and rice, after all the residents have been fed. The other images are some school children in Haiti that we did some with some missionary work. We did some teacher training. And then the one in the center here is a picture of the hospital in Port-au-Prince, where a lot of children are dropped off there by their parents because they just can't afford to take care of them. So this is part of my, as I say, Global Faces collection. And that's about it. I thank you.
Hi, I'm Rochelle Eady. These are my pictures. I'm really excited to be here. This is my first ever art exhibition, but I hope it's not my last one. I don't really know what else to say. I'm just really happy to be here. Well, I've been taking pictures since I was a little kid, but it's the first time I ever did this. And I'm really glad it turned out well. Maybe somebody will buy it, because I need to buy a new camera. Okay. To take pictures? Just a desire to remember what I see. If I see something that I think is beautiful, I just want to remember it, so I take a picture of it. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Jay Harar, and I'm one of the artists here at the Black History Month show. And I'm standing here in front of some of my work. Some of it is just recently completed. This here is my, I call it the tree bark bird. It just spoke to me, certain trees that I see as I'm walking through the city of Ann Arbor, and I just wanted to incorporate some of that texture into the wings of a bird. So it's like, is it the bird in the tree or the tree in the bird? So it's just something that once you stand here, you'll actually see the movement and you can almost hear the ruffling of the bird's wings. So. Oh, no, this is another one of mine. I call this Sorrento Reflected. It was at a visit to Sorrento in Italy. I was actually sitting next to a villa, and there was like water. There had like a pool of water, and just the reflection of the building in that water, it just something about it spoke to me. So I wanted to try to capture that in the work, and I think that I did. So hope you like that. And then this in here is what I call red roses. It's kind of just a clump of red flowers, but the red roses kind of a little have like a slight abstract spin to it, where the roses just kind of pop off out of the floral arrangement. So I hope that you can see where it does that. Mm-hmm. And then this one here is my Jewels of the Sea. My husband and I travel quite frequently, and so we have the opportunity to fly over a lot of bodies of water. And in doing that, in my mind, seeing all the different colors and the coastline and also some of the coral reef colors. So that's what I've tried to capture here in this piece. So thank you.
Okay, first of all, I'm Georgette Jones, and I am a professional artist. I've been doing art since I was 8 years old. And as soon as I started doing art, I knew that it was something I wanted to do for the rest of my life. So I'm inspired by my ideas, by the things that I see around me, by my thoughts and my beliefs, and I just love to paint. This particular piece is called Earth, Sun, and Sky. And as an African American woman, I like to paint I like to paint African-American people, and I also like to paint nature because a lot of my work is very spiritual. And in this painting, I was inspired actually by the sun, the grass, the trees, and the sky. Yes. Okay. And this is acrylic on canvas. Yes. Okay. And this painting is one of my favorite ones. And I like it so much because I have actually painted it twice. The first one I sold about over 10 years ago. And this is the second time I've painted it because it's based on a true experience that my brother, my sister, and I had when we were children. When I was about 4 years old, my brother and my sister and I all slept together in the same bed. And one night, a little Indian girl came into our room, and we were so frightened. You know, we covered up our heads and got really close to each other. And I was the only one that peeked out to see. And once I was the one that was curious, which is part of what an artist does. Curiosity is a big part of an artist's personality. So once I peeked out, they peeked out too. So this painting shows that. It's what's called a conceptual painting. And in the original, the ghost was a child. And this one is a woman. And everybody that sees this painting tells me that she doesn't look like a ghost. She looks like an angel.
I can see why.
Yeah. Yeah, now the background was meant to be semi-abstract, which is one of my, this is my primary way of painting. I tend to put abstract images in the background and figurative images in the foreground.
And you can tell, see that, looking at you guys, oh, what is this? You're quite curious and a little bit,
Mm-hmm.
They are. So, oh, what is this? I'm going to hide.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And I was trying to, in this painting, I showed the expressions on the faces. Because when I do figurative work, I do like to be very expressive. One of the big challenges of this particular painting was taking a subject that might be considered dark and still making it attractive and making it into art. And so I used the bright colors on the quilt. And I think that the bright colors also relate to the children. Children are attracted to bright colors. So that takes away some of the darkness of the subject. Thank you.
And you got one more here that you can give us a little bit of a list.
Okay. This painting is meant to be semi-abstract. It's called Three Spirits, and it has overlapping forms. The faces are not totally realistic. They are overlapping and kind of melting into the background. One of the hallmarks of my paintings is layering. If you look at this, you'll see in the background, in the first layer are pastel colors. You see that? Okay. In the second layer, there's blue, black, green, and then the spirits themselves become brighter. So you have one, two, three layers. Mm-hmm.
That's really nice.
Thank you.
Very nice. And you did a nice presentation.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
And thank you, okay? Very good.
I guess with this piece, I was just trying to focus on the beauty of African-American women because we take a lot of pride in our hair, obviously. So I wanted to focus the main part around the hair, so that's why I chose the hair for the pattern. I think I did a pretty good job of focusing on that beauty. Thank you.
Very detailed.
Yeah.
Long face, the cheekline.
Yeah. Yeah, that's something I've been working on is life drawing too, trying to get the whole realistic look for basically body, drawing the body. So it's a lot of shade work. Yeah.
Very good.
I actually enjoyed doing this piece too. Yeah.
That's what makes it
interesting. Exactly.
It brings life to it.
Yeah, I think this is a theme that I really want to stick with, like the whole line work, shading, making patterns inside of different things. Yeah. But thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm B Positive, and this is my photography. This photo right here represents my lovely dog. It's called Royalty, and I just love it. And I took it as like a individual selfie, but I just propped it up, and there we have it. So it's just in remembrance of him. He passed a few years ago. So he was always a great friend. So, Royalty. This one right here is an actual selfie that I took of myself, and it represents just me loving me and accepting my own beauty. So it's in 3D, and it also just shows the dimensions of me, like my mind, body, and spirit. And then we have B-Man. This one right here just was a happen chance, these last two. I call these my flowers from God. And so I was sitting outside and in the car, and then he just happened to land on my mirror, and I decided to take a picture of him, and I got close, and I got to see, like, oh, he has, like, a mask. So I called him B-Man. And then this is my flower that I love because I just happened to turn around, and here we are. It was just the water. That's how it's the napkin soaked up the water on the countertop, and I just turned around and said, oh, and snapped the picture, and I just call it my flower. So I just love it. It's called For Love. Yeah, and it's the heart, right. Yeah. So it's me, B Positive, signing off.
Thank you.
Okay, hi. So my name is Janelle Robinson, and this piece here is a self-portrait. Basically, someone told me years ago that I was like a flower. I open up one petal at a time. So I wanted to capture that in a painting just to show that you may see me, and you may see a lot of different colors, a lot of different things about me, but I'm not all the way open, but I'm starting to open up a little bit. So, and this painting here is called Love Lifting Me. It's after the hymn about being lost in a sea of sin, and the love of God lifted you up out of it. So basically, you're being lifted up by love, and then you're carrying off that love to someone else. So that's it.
Sure. Y'all done?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Hi, my name is Lauren Mills, and these three are my paintings. The first is called Uplifting the Common Man. I have a guy with a crown on and some just regular clothes. He was supposed to be a homeless man, but I gave him a crown because I feel like regular people are ignored So that's where this title came from. And this one right here, it's called Artificial Plant. And the caption says, can't grow a black boy without roots. And so you have this guy here, and he has a noose around his neck because he didn't know where he came from. And yeah, there's that one. And this one I based off of Billie Holiday's song Strange Fruit and tried to imitate the parallel themes in the verses of the songs. So it was meant to be beautiful and haunting at the same time.
I'm Ashanti. This is my piece, Magic Mona. I created this piece because I was doing a project in school where we were trying to incorporate something from our daily lives into art. And when I showed my teacher the kente cloth, he didn't look at it as art. So I kind of like threw it in there, because when you think of the Mona Lisa, that's just the epitome of all art. So I'm like, what if I mix that with it? Would you see it as art now? And so that's how it kind of went. And then I went from there. First it was produced digitally, but I thought it would look better to see the textures, you know, actually. And I had so much spare kente cloth that, you know, so this is my piece.
Hi, my name is Gigi. What inspired me to do these pieces are just the beauty of women from all over the world. They all represent many different races, nationalities, religions, because I feel in just the history of all humans, women kind of take the shadow and really understanding our presence and our power and what we've contributed. So through my art with color and some tribal symbolism, I just like to highlight the most beautiful parts and aspects of women from all over the world.
Okay, my name is Bria Irby, and these are my pieces. Voyage to the Motherland, Martin and Coretta, Peace of Mind, and Malcolm Boulevard. I work with African-American figures as my subjects, and I do pen and Prisma marker as my predominant medium. I also did these pieces in different stages of my life, and so they correlate with some of the events that I was going through, dealing with identity, entering college, and finding out about the motherland as I left high school and dealing with love and civil figures going into school. Yeah. What other inspirations inspire me? Other inspirations that inspire me are women. I also try to incorporate women into my artwork, being an African-American woman, and also quotes by African-American women that inspire me and uplift me as an artist. Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
I'm Melissa Calfan. With this piece titled Wound, I wanted to talk about how America really admires and likes black culture, yet African-Americans were marginalized and criminalized in our society despite America's fascination with our culture. So I really want to communicate my disappointment with the United States and how they treat us. So with the gunshot wounds, I wanted to allude to recent events that have occurred in our country and throughout all of history. That's basically the rundown with this piece. I would say my inspiration comes from just current events like Trayvon Martin and other young people who've been killed by police brutality and just the way our society is run.
Thank you. My name is Kavana Smith, and I'm a freshman at Eastern Michigan, and my major is art. I want to be an art teacher. This piece right here is called Buried Alive, and it's basically about the weight that people feel when they go throughout life. I feel that sometimes people allow things to bury them, and since you're still living, it's called Buried Alive, and that doesn't have a good connotation with it. And this piece right here is called Dining with Destiny, and it's a fun piece. It has no real deep meaning to it, but I do think it's fun to see the self in a different way than how you really look. This piece is called Your Body is a Wonderland, and it's basically about how sometimes people don't appreciate their own body and they forget that they are life and they are love. And so I basically wanted to let people know that your body is a wonderland. And if you think back to childhood, playing on the slide and on the swing, it's fun. And so I just want to bring that beauty back to your body. Love yourself. This last piece is my favorite piece. It's called Octopus, and my favorite animal is an octopus, so I thought it would be fun to see what I would look like with an octopus tentacle. So I appreciate this piece very much. It's my favorite.
All right, my name is Crystal Nicole, and these here are my pieces. This one is just a compilation of sports teams in Detroit, because I am from Detroit, or sports teams that were in Detroit, because that one down there is the Shock logo and they're no longer in Detroit. That piece there depicts what it's like to be an African-American woman in America. So it's kind of always trying to balance fitting in and being yourself. That one right there, called Inhale. It actually was a set called Breathe, and the other one said Exhale, and I just thought it was cool, but yeah. And the last one is called Diamond, and it was painted for a Kappa that I know, so it's called Diamond for their whole frat thing. Yeah.
Next, we're going to move to this lone soul standing up here waiting. This is Hanif Sabri, and he is our literary artist, a poetry writer, and he has his book here. And he is going to share with us a page, whatever he's inspired to do here for us. Do you need this, or are you just going to express yourself? You would use this? All right, I'm going to turn the mic over to Hanif, and he's going to perform one of his poems for us.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Once again, my name is Hanif Sabri. I have three pieces tonight. The first one is titled Words of a Soldier. Then we have True Retrospect. And I want to conclude fittingly with good night. This is Words of a Soldier. No, my life hasn't been the best. There's only a few that I survived upon leaving the nest. There's always jokes about the ghettos and pens, but I don't see not one thing funny. Especially when my homie just got smoked for less than money. It's like walking a balance beam without a day's worth of training, which eventually can become physically and mentally drained. But something deep down just won't let me quit. Even though that drama is getting way too thick. Will I grow old? Seems like a cloudy thought. Since each new day another brother has dropped. Regardless though, the true power and knowledge must be sought. Real honor and recognition can never be bought. As a young brother lose being outlined in white chalk. Next we have True Retrospect. In retrospect of history, society too frequently claims I don't have one. But through my ancestors, the first forms of government and civilizations begun. In retrospect of history, all those inventions that you use every single day, imagine what would life be like if they remained tucked away. In retrospect of history, we used to network and operate as one community. But now due to brainwashing, and I got mine, you get yours, or I don't have mine, so now I'm gonna take yours. It's a new immunity. In retrospect of history, our textbooks consistently construct timelines, beginning at slavery. The audacity to upkeep that fallacy still amazes me. In retrospect of history, you embark on great kings and queens, such as Imhotep, Akhenaten, Hatshepsut, and Nefertari. that ignited a rich and illustrious tradition far from theory. In retrospective history, unyielding physical, emotional, psychological battles endured, resulting in the blood of mighty and courageous souls being poured. In retrospective history, conceptualized a tree stabilized by its roots. Now distort history, and that same tree becomes weak and loose. Now we have good night. Rest well, my angel. Relax your thoughts. No worries tonight. It'll all work out. Dream on, dream on. When we meet this time, just close your eyes and let your mind unwind. Your feet are weary. You worked so hard today. As you rest for you, unyielding happiness and security, I pray. When the sun comes up, we'll tackle this world together. Together. Okay? Once again, my name is Hanif Sabri. I'm the author of Trumpet of Peace and Peace.
Okay, now we have a dance performance tonight.
Okay.
Alright.
You better dance that.
By Miriam Johnson. She is an EMU student, and after I invited her to do this for us, I found out that she is one of the teachers next door in our dance studio.
Seven feet. Rain together for the wind.
ends our little short program. I think all of the artists have been interviewed now. Artists, I want you to be brave and hold up your hand if you have not been interviewed. Okay? Got it? And? All right. We kind of have your interview, your entire performances, but it would also be nice to actually have our cameraman in. Okay, so head on back to your art pieces, people that want to talk to you. We have a little bit of food left. Also, before the evening is over, we actually have another exhibit in the building. So if you have the time and can make it, over in our off center, which is the other half of our complex, the easiest way to get to it is right out the front door, down the sidewalk, and into the front door of that building. And there we have an exhibit by the youth. So you may want to check that out before the evening is over. Okay, so thank you all for coming. Please talk with the artists, including the literary and the dancer, and enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Okay, so my name is Miriam Johnson, and the piece I just performed is called Oh My America. I felt inspired to do this piece after the multiple police brutality cases that were coming out, and I had noticed in my courses, because I'm also African American Studies and Dance at Eastern Michigan University, a correlation between the lynchings of the early 1900s and the police brutality cases. And so I started choreographing, doing a comparison between the two, and just felt the need to say something with my art about what was happening.
Yes, my name is Hanif Sabri, and I'm from Eastern Michigan. And just to give you a summation of what inspires me or what inspired me to put together and create my editorial debut, I would say first off, writing has always been one of my passions for years, along with being, say, a youth advocate, and also just trying to make society as a whole more aware. And so I was able to actually bring that to fruition through my editorial debut, Trump in a Fixed Deck. It touches on a wide range of topics. The main component is poetry. And so that's some of the background on that in terms of my sense of inspiration, was just enlightening people at the same time while I'm elevating myself. Thank you.